I heard ghosts on the whole record, you know?
You mean in a weird place spiritually?
Yeah, it was just a fun place to be. Like, I heard ghosts on the whole record, and I'd always say to people when we were playing it for them, we were recording them, I'd say, don't you hear those ghosts? Listen. And so we'd go, John. And I'd say to people when we were playing it for them, we were recording them, I'd say, don't you hear those ghosts? Listen. And so we'd go, John. I'd say, don't you hear those ghosts? Listen. And so we'd go, John. Not everybody hears them. Just we hear them.
Crazy bastard in the clip you just watched is John Frusciante of the Red Hot Chili Peppers. He is known for his unique style of guitar playing, which stems from rock, funk, electronic, and avant-garde music. He is a modern version of Jimi Hendrix, David Bowie, and Frank Zappa all rolled into one. With that being said, his main guitars are 1960s and even 1990s Fender Stratocasters. Although his main axe is a 1962 Stratocaster that he bought with the help of Anthony Kiedis in the late 1990s. But this wasn't his holy grail guitar. That was his 1958 Stratocaster with the wrong neck that he used for the iconic album, Blood Sex, Sugar, Magik. This album was emotional funk and rage, with such powerful and important guitar tracks. This was the Chili Peppers' greatest album that they ever produced. And that made the 1958 Stratocaster one of the most important guitars of the 1990s sound. This was like Eddie Van Halen's Frankenster guitar. It was a guitar we all should be talking about today. What pickups did he use? What type of wood was the body? What strings were on it? You get the picture. But one must ask, where the hell is this guitar? In order to understand why the 1958 Strat disappeared, we must first come to an understanding of why John quit the band in mid-1992. According to grunge.com, all those issues came to a head on May 7, 1992, when Frusciante announced that he was leaving the Peppers, just one day after they kicked off their tour of Japan. Despite his bandmates' best efforts to convince him to stay, Frusciante had made up his mind, and when he did, he embarked on a solo career that didn't yield much commercial success. His use of drugs, particularly cocaine and heroin, likewise escalated during his time away from the Peppers. Even though he overdosed in February 1996, the Axeman kept on with his $500-a-day drug habit and was even homeless at one point after failing to pay his rent.
I said all over the country, and then I realized, Jesus, all over the world. And I said it to Flea like five different ways, and he was going, yeah.
According to Paul Branigan of Loudersound.com, he overdosed in February that year, a result of his body containing, he estimated, just 1/12 of the blood it was supposed to have. After getting a blood transfusion, his first thought, he later recalled, was great, I'm good to go again. Let me get my hands on some more drugs. From this point, the guitarist was spending up to $500 per day on his habit. With only royalty checks keeping him afloat, this was always going to lead to problems. At one point, Frusciante owed $30,000 to his drug dealer and had to beg for cash from his friends to avoid taking a bullet in the head. That same year, he was kicked out of his house for not paying his rent. Drug addiction combined with having no money meant the 1958 Strat had to be sold off. And it was. According to online sources, the Strat was purchased on eBay during John's junkie years for around $10,000. It is well taken care of and gets played on occasion. And most importantly, it is not for sale.
Thank you.